So what's the most important aircraft in the Air Force inventory? Fighters? Bombers? Not at all. It's a KC-135, because without fuel from the stratotanker, you're not getting the fighters or the bombers like this to the target.
This is a KC-135 stratotanker. And Chief Pilot, Lieutenant Colonel Wilkes, says this aircraft serves more than just the Air Force.
507th, we're doing worldwide air refueling support of our allied and United States Air Force, Navy, Marine.
Even though the KC-135 is over 60 years old, it was over-designed, a very capable platform.
But it's a flying gas station. We hold up to 200,000 pounds of aviation fuel, and we make sure that we can do the job anytime we have to.
Our mission of the day was refueling six F-16s from the Oklahoma Air Guard unit out of Tulsa. Boom operator Tech Sergeant Ladd gave us our mission briefing.
We're going to refuel them one by one, or giving them 2K offload today.
All right, we're clear for takeoff.
Our flight of two KC-135s headed to a military training zone in Kansas, flying in formation.
McConnell Air Force Base over there, Wichita Mid-Continent's right in front of us over here.
Once the fighters arrived, we flew in a circular orbit to stay in the simulated combat airspace.
Switch this over to range control so we can hear the fighters.
Stationed in the rear of the stratotanker, Tech Sergeant Ladd controls a fuel boom while laying prone.
I enjoy it. It gives me a peace of mind while I'm back there air refueling. It makes me feel important that I'm directly impacting the mission.
One by one, we refueled each F-16, taking less than 10 minutes of fuel each.
Altitude.
Want to go?
Approaching.
Acknowledged.
Not only is the KC-135 built for in-flight refueling, it can also be configured for cargo.
Depending on fuel configuration, the KC-135 can carry up to 83,000 pounds of cargo and passengers. Because this aircraft is so old, it cannot fly without the dedication of the maintenance crews.
We maintain a high rate of readiness so that when we call in our people, who are mostly traditional reservists who have a daytime job somewhere else, they have to be able to come here fully trained and be gone within that 72-hour period.
First, incredible footage there, but as an Air Force veteran yourself, this was pretty special that you got a chance to work on this.
That was part of my job. I was load plan qualified. Mm-hmm. I could load plan that aircraft. But let me tell you, Lieutenant Colonel Wilkes and Tech Sergeant Ladd, amazing ambassadors for the Air Force Reserve. So well spoken and professional, made me feel like I was just part of the team. And again, the Air Force cannot do their mission without the tankers. You need fuel, fighters, bombers, and the cargo aircraft.
And I like that they were able to break it down and simplify it for those of us who are not in the Air Force.
Yeah, it was so cool to be a part of that. Mm-hmm.